charge of you day and night, night and day. Why is it so that this longing for you follows wherever I go?
One, contributions live in all of us who play this music. So anyway, we're here to celebrate his 105th birthday. It actually is Monday, but at 105 years, what's a couple of days? We'd like to continue with something that I believe he wrote, but my memory serves me correctly, and I should know I wrote a book about this, but this next tune, I believe, was written for a recording made by Milt Jackson with a big band and all sorts of strings and stuff, and maybe it didn't have strings, but anyway, it was one of his from his late period. He was born, obviously, in 1917, and he died, unfortunately, at 48 years old in 1965. But this was recorded in his late period after 1961. And anyway, it's called Beautifully Adorned, and we're going to do it as a cha-cha. Let's see. Yeah, we come in on the band. Hey, two. Oh. Thank you. slightly different version that Tad had written for Woody Herman, and it was called a Slight Groove or something like that, and was a feature for his trombonist, name is escaping me now, great trombone player who played in the band at the time. From 1956 that was written. Anyway, The Rampage. So, chill out a little bit after that. Tad Dameron began his career, well, he began his career right out of high school, as far as I could tell. He did tell a fib about going to Oberlin and studying medicine, but that, no. He was a funny guy. He never fibbed about the music he actually wrote, but he did tell a lot of fibs, I'm afraid. Anyway, we're going to do something that was one of the very first things that he wrote that was recorded in 1940 by a band from Kansas City. This was the Kansas City Rockets of Harlan Leonard. And he was inspired to write this by a wonderful tenor saxophonist in the band, a guy named Henry Bridges, who was, had he chosen to go on after World War II, probably would have emerged as one of the well-known players. But he decided to get out of music, at least as a profession, after he did his service in the war. Anyway, it's called A La Bridges, and as the wonderful Myra Taylor, who was singer with that band, phrased it, she said, it's a ballad with a beat. Last four. One, two, one. And it was recorded. It was recorded by the great character and scat singer and entertainer, a guy named Babs Gonzalez. And they recorded that. I think actually on my very birthday in 1946. Anyway, aww. Yeah. They knew. And the interesting thing about this tune is it started off as a jingle that Tad wrote for Woody Herman a couple of years earlier. It was supposed to be a jingle for Woody's sponsor, Wild Root Cream Oil, the hair tonic. Only they never got used because they changed the sponsor. So Tad repurposed it when he joined with Babs Gonzalez as the Bip. He was Babs Gonzalez and his three bops and a Bip. So we'd like to continue with something now from the late period of Tad's writing. Let me make sure I get the right part. This one's got a chart. And we recorded this on the album that I put out on the Summit label called Unknown Dameron. So we've done this in a number of different ways, so I merged different arrangements together and came up with this. But excuse me a moment, it's getting warm in here. Even though it's supposed to be really chilly tonight. Anyhow, Tad wrote several songs with words in that last period of his life, and this was one of them. And it tells a story, as you shall hear, of a little fling up in ski country. So Kathy is going to sing. this. And we're ready to go with that? Yeah, okay. I think I'm feeling it just a hair slower than we did it earlier. One, a two, a one, a two.
Toboggans, we're flying through. So, Paul, I have to ask you, have you had a weekend like that? I've got my best friend over there, so don't say anything. I mean, cause she might know. But
well, I can't ski, so.
Well, it's said toboggan. It said toboggan.
Yeah, well, yeah, there's the toboggan. Yeah, that's true.
But, geez, like Maine, December, toboggan and night? I'm just thinking when I'm singing, I'm like, that's really cold.
Yes, yes.
That's what I thought.
Like a personal injury case.
That's what I know. That's yeah. What I thought. That's not what you thought of lyrics. Yeah. Okay. That's what I'm thinking.
Oh, my.
Yeah. The lyrics.
Okay.
You should probably turn me off.
That's all right. Comic relief. Dear, what's going to happen then? Right. This is for the streaming audience especially, because I believe everybody in this room knows all the folks who are on the bandstand, but I haven't announced them. So, Kathy Shoemaker at the piano. Rob Thorson is a bass. Richard Sellers. My name is Paul Combs, and thank you. And you folks. folks are wonderful to come out and join us this evening. So we're going to play one of Ted's well-known tunes. I'm not going to tell you what it is, but if you like this music, you probably will recognize it. And I like to do it a little faster than most people think, but Ted actually recorded it this way, too. So.
Thank you.
They remember John Coltrane.
Yeah.
Oh, I shouldn't even go down there. it's been very frustrating trying to get some traction with proper appreciation for Tad Dameron. When I came out with this book, the book I wrote on him was published by a reputable academic press, University of Michigan Press, part of their jazz series. And we sent a copy to Downbeat, and they sent a copy to Jazz Times, and a copy to International Musician, and none of them ever reviewed the book, which is not about me, it's about him, you know, hey guys, you know. And it's been like that, so it's all the more reason it's great to have you folks here with us. We're going to do another of his very well-known tunes, his best-known ballad. And he wrote this in 1946, a little before I was born, just by a few months, for a date, a recording date with Sarah Vaughan. Now, it's interesting because he ended up, he mentored a lot of people. And one of them was Sarah Vaughan. He mentored Sarah Vaughan. He mentored Miles Davis. He mentored Benny Golson. He mentored Charlie Rouse. And there were a whole host of others who saw him as a mentor, just from casually talking with him or just from listening to his recordings in the late 40s, which includes Horace Silver. See, he made these recordings in the late 40s that pointed directly to what small group jazz was going to be doing in the 50s. You know, so he's just, anyway. But enough of that. It's a lovely tune. Sarah recorded it. It's probably one of his very most well-known tunes. And Kathy, we are fortunate, is going to sing it for you.
Hello? Test? I hear something somewhere. Is that okay? That's better.
You'd know how blue I've been. One look is all you need to see the mood I'm in. Perhaps then you'd realize I'm still in love with you. See me now, you'd find I'm being brave and trying very hard to make my tears behave. But that's quite impossible. I'm still in love with you. Thank you.
The lyric for that song was written by a great lyricist, a man named Carl Sigman. I wrote, I didn't understand just how many songs he's written until his son sent me a 4-CD set of all the things that Sigman had written lyrics for. They covered a whole swath of popular music, not just jazz. In 1956, around the same time that one that we played earlier, The Rampage, was written, and also On a Misty Night, Tad wrote this little waltz, and it just was there in the Library of Congress, and it's only recently, it was in sort of a copyright purgatory for quite some time. They seem to have gotten that resolved, because there is a Tad Dameron vocal album coming out soon. The good news, great players, the great baritone saxophonist Gary Smulyan put this together, a wonderful young singer, a gal named Anais Reno. I look her up, and she's only 18. She's just terrific. So that's the good news. They've done this. The bad news, it's on this label run by this crazy guy from Scandinavia, who doesn't do any promo. So it's on the Steeplechase label out of Denmark. But if you're jazz record collectors, then you probably know about Steeplechase. And if you want afterwards to give me your email, if you don't, I'll put you on my email mailing list. I send out a newsletter every month, and I will be happy to keep you apprised of when that comes out. I've heard some of it, and it's going to be wonderful. Anyway, it's called This Night of Stars.
This night of stars is ours, is ours. Let's take it while we may. A million tiny twinkling eyes shine down from us on purple skies. Come here to me, come near to me, so dear to me you are. Oh, say you care and help me share this. Come here to me, come dear to me, so near.
John Thorson. Tad Dameron. And I, Paul Combs, thank you all very much for coming out to spend this evening with us, this beautiful night of stars. We're going to finish with one last tune. This one's got an arrangement, and the arrangement is basically an adaptation from the arrangement that Tad Dameron actually wrote of this. Now, among the many things that he did, you know, is that he mentored people, he wrote a lot of wonderful tunes and one. He's a very, very, very important arranger in writing for large ensembles and small ensembles. Even small ensembles, the great arranger and saxophonist Frank Foster told me that he learned the fundamentals of arranging from listening to Tad's small group recordings, and he built up from there. So this was something that Tad wrote for Jimmy Lunsford. Jimmy Lunsford, for it was a long time ago, but in back in the swing era, Jimmy Lunsford's band was huge. I mean, he was on, in terms of popularity, on the same level with Ellington and Benny Goodman and so on. And Tad worked for him for a while and then continued writing, submitting charts after he left. And this was one that he wrote in the mid-40s when the big bands were trying to catch up with what the boppers were doing. And it's called Zakat. And Zakat is one of the seven principles of Islam. There were some musicians in the band who had converted to Islam. Tad didn't, but he listened to what they told him about it. So anyway, this is called Zakat. Zakat is the giving of alms. And we thank for all the alms that are the blessings that we all receive in this life. So let me look at the plan. Okay. Why don't you go first? With Richard, and we're good. Okay, we have a plan. Unfortunately, I don't get to play with these folks often enough, so we have to remind ourselves. But you're jazz fans, so you know how this goes. So. Excuse me, everybody.
What do I know?
It threw me off, so I had to stop. All right. A one, a two, a one, two, three.